You walk into this room at your own risk, because it leads to the future. Not a future that will be, but one that might be. This is not a new world. It is simply an extension of what began in the old one. It has patterned itself after every dictator who has ever planted the ripping imprint of a boot on the pages of history since the beginning of time. It has refinements, technological advances, and a more sophisticated approach to the destruction of human freedom. But like every one of the superstates that preceded it, it has one iron rule. Logic is an enemy and truth is a menace. This is Mr. Romney Wordsworth in his last 48 hours on Earth. He's a citizen of his state, but will soon have to be eliminated because he's built out of flesh and because he has a mind.
Do you know why you're here, Mr. Wordsworth?
Yes, sir.
I'd ask you to speak up a little, if you will.
Yes, sir, I know why I'm here.
You've been under investigation, Mr. Wordsworth, for the mandatory period of 1 year and 11 months. You're found to be obsolete. The purpose of this hearing is to make a finding in the matter and make a sentence accordingly. Do you understand that?
I understand that.
Your occupation, Mr. Wordsworth?
A librarian,
sir. A what?
A librarian, sir.
Since there are no more books, Mr. Wordsworth, there are no more libraries. And of course it follows that there is very little call for the services of a librarian. Now I ask you again, your occupation?
I am a librarian, sir. That is my occupation. That is my profession. If you people choose to call that obsolete...
Request clarification of the term?
Yes, the term, Mr. Wordsworth, you people, you make reference to the state?
I make reference to the state.
And you persist in declaring your occupation as being that of a librarian, is that correct?
That is correct, sir.
A librarian. Having to do with books.
Yes, sir. Books.
You are obsolete, Mr. Wordsworth.
A lie. No man is obsolete.
You have no function, Mr. Wordsworth. You're an anachronism, like a ghost from another time.
I am nothing more than a reminder to you that you cannot destroy truth by burning pages.
You're a bug, Mr. Wordsworth, a crawling insect, an ugly, misformed little creature who has no purpose here, no meaning.
I am a human being.
You're a librarian, Mr. Wordsworth. You're a dealer in books and 2-cent fines and pamphlets and closed stacks and the musty insides of a language factory that spews out meaningless words on an assembly line. Words, Mr. Wordsworth, that have no substance and no dimension, like air, like the wind, like a vacuum that you make believe has an existence by scribbling index numbers on little cards.
I don't care. I tell you, I don't care. I'm a human being. I exist. And if I speak one thought aloud, that thought lives even after I'm shoveled into my grave.
You waste our time, Mr. Wordsworth, and you're not worth the waste. Instruct him.
Romney Wordsworth, step back to await the finding of this board.
Yes, sir.
How do you find, ladies and gentlemen?
Obsolete.
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 I concur.
Romney Wordsworth, step forward. The board finds you obsolete.
Any state, any entity, any ideology that fails to recognize the worth, the dignity, the rights of man, that state is obsolete.